In the small town of Kotavali in Bulandshahr, Uttar Pradesh, a mob surrounded the UP police at 1:30 p.m. on the afternoon of December 3, 2018. Angered after finding cow carcasses strewn across a farm in the nearby Maha village, they threw stones at the police station and demanded,
"Arrest the cow killers!"
As the violence escalated, Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh saw some men at a distance cutting a tree, laying its branches and trunk across the road in an attempt to disrupt traffic, and rushed there to stop them. In an unnecessarily violent response, the tree cutter named Kalua, aka Rajiv, attacked Inspector Subodh Kumar with the axe. One of the blows hit him on the head, chopping off his thumb as he tried to protect himself. Trapped and wounded, he drew his weapon in a last-ditch attempt to save his life. The bullets hit one of the troublemakers, Sumit Kumar, squarely in the abdomen, a wound from which he later died. Incensed at being fired upon, Prashant Nath, whose other job was that of a Delhi taxi driver, attacked Singh.
"Take away his gun! Give him him!"
Using the inspector's own license .32 ball revolver to shoot him. For reasons unknown, they took away all his three mobiles before fleeing the spot. Though Nath and the others were arrested later, the gun was never recovered. When Singh's driver Ram Ashray tried to take the injured officer to the hospital,
"Let me through, he has been shot, have to get to hospital."
They refused and began attacking the police jeep, forcing the driver to run away to save his own life, while Singh succumbed to his bullet injuries at the spot. Shamelessly, a compensation of 10 lakhs was given to the family of the man who was part of the mob that ended up killing Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh, absolving the administration of the blame by holding the other police officers responsible for the inspector's death.
"We have transferred 9 officers for negligence, including the senior superintendent of police, Krishna Bahadur Singh."
In an effort to save face, they named 27 people in a FIR, including Bajrang Dal member Yogesh Raj, besides 50 to 60 unknown persons who attacked the police at Chingravati Chowki. To appease the protesters, they filed a FIR against the alleged cow killers, partly based on a statement made by the same Yogesh Raj, who ran away soon thereafter. He claimed to have seen 7 people slaughtering cows, after which he raised an alarm and left the scene. However, in a later video statement released while on the run from the law, "When I got information about the cow slaughter, I reached there with my supporters." Raj contradicted his own FIR. Rajkumar Chaudhary, on whose fields the cow carcasses were found on the morning of December 3rd, also contradicts Raj.
"I was at home at 7 a.m. in the morning when a villager informed me about the dead animals in my field."
Tehsildar Rajkumar Bhaskar, one of the first administrative officers to reach the spot in Maha village, "I saw the head and skin of a dead cow hung in a sugarcane field. Why would anyone publicly display a cow carcass in today's times?" Army Jawan Jitendra Malik, also a resident of Maha village, was later arrested as part of the mob, but not for the killing of Inspector Singh. A total of 31 arrests have been made so far. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath tried to play down the incident as something minor.
"What happened in Bulandshahr was an accident."
But it was much more than an accident. Yogi's own Deputy General of Police, OP Singh, called the Bulandshahr incident a big conspiracy. "How did the cattle carcass reach there? Who brought it? And why?" According to the veterinarian's report, the cow carcasses were over 48 hours old. As it turns out, the investigation officer of the 2015 lynching by cow rakshaks of 52-year-old Mamad Aklak in Dadri, UP was none other than Subodh Kumar Singh himself. Singh's prompt action in bringing the evidence samples to the lab in time helped the UP veterinary department confirm that the meat was mutton and not beef. Even the charge sheet does not mention the type of meat. He also arrested 10 of the accused in the lynching. But despite his commendable job, even before the charge sheet could be filed against the accused, he was transferred to Varanasi for conducting a biased investigation. Because of his transfer and subsequent delay in filing the charge sheet for 4 months, all the 10 accused were given bail and are still roaming free. Singh's sister Renu Singh is categorical.
"My brother's investigation of Mohammed Akhlaq's lynching was the motive behind his cold-blooded murder."
Suresh Kumar Singh, Chingrabati's outpost in charge's transfer after the murder of his fellow officer was greeted with sweets and flowers by Saffron Group workers.
We have finally been successful in getting SSP Singh transferred.
How frivolously police filed FIRs without a shred of evidence was shown when all seven named in the fake FIR for cow slaughter were set free. Four others took their place instead. This incident need not have occurred at all. Maha village is equally divided between Jats and Jatavars, and there are just 12 Muslim families. While the villagers themselves were resolving the cow carcasses row internally, outsiders from the Bajrang Dal interrupted them, loaded the carcasses into a tractor and took it towards the Bulandshahr Gair Mukteshwar State Highway, passing near a 10 lakh strong congregation of Muslims attending a religious function. Imagine if the members of the two communities had clashed. The result would have been much more devastating. At that time, assembly elections in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh were just days away. Was this an attempt to kill two birds with one stone? Kill the officer who had jailed Gau Rakshaks and polarize the public to vote for the BJP? 83 former bureaucrats sent an open letter to Prime Minister Modi and urged, "Citizens should seek the resignation of Chief Minister Yogi for allowing fundamentalist tendencies to prosper and has failed to uphold the constitution." Noted actor Nasiruddin Shah and his wife Ratna Pathak put out a video blog.
"In today's India, a cow's death seems more important than a cop's life."
The words of an anguished son of the slain inspector look prophetic.
"My father was killed by religious bigots trying to trigger communal violence. Whose father will be next?"
Within a month, Head Constable Pratap Singh Vats was killed when a mob hurled stones on police trying to control a crowd. His son Suresh Vats spoke the same words as Abhishek Singh. Just as politicians cannot interfere in the army or the judicial system, the Ministry of Home Affairs should not be allowed to control the Indian police force. See how politicians made a mess of the CBI. Bisbo's limerick. In today's India, a cow is worth more than a cop. The banning of beef is a fundamentalist sop, giving them license to kill, for which the country pays the bill. The government must ensure that these lynchings stop. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.